All right, so I decided to go through Sportsman's guide or whatever to buy my ammo. One of the guys on one of the forums gave me a pretty good discount code and free shipping, so it's one of the cheapest places I can go to get it. Ended up buying some 357 Magnum for my Ruger GP. I'm going to throw a video of that pretty soon, hopefully. And then I ended up buying some Russian surplus 7.62x39 cheap, like, surplus ammunition, whatever. But the reason why I'm making a video of this is because I see a lot of guys talking about Sportsman's Guide and how they have really shitty packaging and really shitty quality and all that stuff. So I just figured I'd make this just to clear it up. Maybe everybody else's things are different or whatever, the shipments are different, but this is what I'm getting, so I didn't see any of that, so I'm just going to put a video out to maybe squash that. Maybe it's just a rumor like most stuff on the internet. But pretty much just open the box. You can see it's 7.62x39, full metal jacket. On their website, all it said was Russian surplus. But apparently it's WPA, don't know who that is. Made in Russia, which I think all of this ammo is, all the cheap ammo. I don't remember what price I got it for, but it was pretty cheap. I think it was like $200-$300. Comes individually packaged, comes with, I think this is like 25 rounds, or 20 cartridges right there, WPA, 7.62x39, full metal jacket, steel case, don't really know anything else of that, because I am new to an AK. It's getting out on Sunday, which is in like 2 days, but this is how it comes packaged. I've seen a lot of people talk about how it's just in a baggie in the box, and then like my full metal jacket or my 5.56 was from Palmetto. It's just in a bag with like a bunch of ammo in it, and then just tie it and throw it in the box. This is actually packaged better, and people talk about having loose ammo. It's not, at least the stuff that I bought. It comes in this like paper wrap. It's like a package. It's wrapped all the way around it. And they're like individually separated by like every five or whatever. But that's not too bad. It is magnetic ammo. But like I said, it's not too bad. I haven't shot the ammo yet. But the packaging isn't too bad. I see a lot of people talking trash about how they have really shitty shipping. And I'm actually going to unbox the 357 Magnum right now so you guys can see that. I haven't gotten to it yet. I just wanted to check out the 7.62x39. So, put you guys on the tripod. Zoom in. And go ahead and open it up. I only ordered 500 rounds of this. I'm going to get another 500 rounds of 30 special. Probably going to be shooting that more. Comes with standard packaging. And then it's the Fiocchi cheap stuff. I don't really know much about this. It's the shooting dynamics. Figured I'd make this. I'm probably going to get some dies and reload mount stuff, but I figured I'd try this out pretty cheap. Comes in, and it comes with holders. That's pretty cool. I was looking for one to throw in the safe to hold my 357. But yeah, just pretty standard. It's not really a, it's almost like a wad cutter, but it's not. It's not really a, I'm not really sure about that. Maybe you guys can see it. I don't know too much about these either, but yeah, pretty basic, just like you get at the gun store. I think I paid like $200 for like all 500 rounds. This is how it comes shipped, just like that. Again, there's no rounds floating in the box like everybody complains about. There's no, every couple are missing. I heard rumors of people that got ammo and it was outside the boxes floating around in the big box, and the bullet came out and powder was all over the place. I don't see that. Again, they probably ordered different ammo or something like that. It could happen. Just showing this is how my stuff came packaged. The only downside for them that I don't like, another thing too, is they don't ship to some places of California, which a lot of places don't, and like Missouri and stuff like that. It's your local gun laws. It's not the store themselves. It's a protocol. So go look that stuff up. But the only thing I don't like about them is tons of junk mail. Jewelry, like makeup, perfume, car ads, some kind of sweepstakes. this come like everybody sends their catalog so you can buy more of their stuff, and then their sale catalog, and then just tons of junk. Here's the invoices. You know, I'll read it off. This is all subject to change. I got $214.99 for the 1,000 rounds of Full Metal Jacket, 7.62x39, and then $214.99 for, nope, that's for... Okay, $174.90 for the 357 Magnum, which is still pretty cheap. And then I got a sleeping the bed mattresses Magic Jack. Just a ton of bullshit that you don't really need. It's just gonna go right in the trash. But as far as the ammo being shipped weird or whatever cheaply, it's shipped like everybody else. So gonna try and do some testing on that through the AK. It's probably gonna work fine. Ended up picking up a Wasser 10, 63, and then I don't have any doubts that this stuff's gonna shoot. But I just figured I'd just show you guys how it comes packaged. Cause I know a lot of people talk shit about this specific website about how they ship their stuff. So hopefully that helps somebody if somebody's on the fence of buying from them. There you go. That's how it shipped, at least WPA and the Fiocchi ammunition. And I assume most of it is, unless the manufacturer keeps it in a baggie and then they just throw it in a box. Nothing they can do about it. So, again, and then the shipping time was normal. I think I ordered it on, like, Monday or what, maybe, like, Saturday or some shit. And it got here in, like, 5 days, so nothing too bad. So, again, just showing you guys what I got and how it comes. So, take it easy. Yeah, another thing I just wanted to add to onto this video is, as you can see there, if it focuses up a little bit, it says Buyers Club, and then it says non-members. Pretty much you can see the difference. So the thing is pretty much if you're one of their members, you get better pricing, but it's like $30 a month or $30, I don't know, it's kind of expensive. And I did the breakdown, and unless you're buying shit from them like candy, the prices don't really help you out, and you end up spending more than you would just being a non-member. So it's another thing, and it's on everything. So I don't know if they raise the prices, probably, because I wouldn't doubt that they'd lose profit for members. But yeah, it sucks. It's just for everything. And the ammo I could have bought for a little bit cheaper, but again, it's got a buyer's club. But personally, I don't think it's worth it whatsoever unless you're buying tons of shit. But I just want to point that out. It's the only other downside on top of it. So yeah, that's pretty much about it. So just want to throw that in there.